not that unusual when everything is beautiful. It's just another ordinary miracle today. The sky knows when it's time to snow. Don't need to teach a seed to grow. It's just another ordinary miracle today. Life is like a gift they say, wrapped up for you every day. Open up and find a way to give some of your own.
I was so impressed with the wall of spirit when you walk in the door, and it's so hard to explain either on video or on the radio or anything. You have to actually come here to see it. Once the door opens, it's like something that hits you. And that's what really impresses me. Sure, there's nice furniture. Sure, there's nice pictures on the wall. Sure, there's nice friendly people. But it's just a whole feeling that greets you.
My grandmother died of colon cancer many years ago when I was just 12. And I always thought once I experienced and came on the tour of Gildathon Club that what a great place this would have been for me and my brother and my sister and my mom and everyone in my family to come and, you know, get some support and, you know, participate in some of the groups and get some laughs.
The best thing about Gildathon Club is just being able to come here and be yourself. If you come here and you don't feel well, you can just come into one of these rooms and have a nap. If you don't feel well, you can just go in and have your low tea with everyone, and you leave and you're replenished. You just feel so much better because everyone here understands what's happening to you and why you feel the way you do. And that's what's so good about building. You can be yourself. And that actually is Gildathon's motto. Come as yourself. Be yourself.
For me,
it's like my second home. I come here most days of the week with something that I'd like to do, and it takes me away from the things that I'm having to deal with on a day-to-day basis, like the chemo, like the radiation, and the specialist appointments, and so on and so forth. And this, when Gilda formulated what she wanted as an idea of somewhere for people to go for cancer support, she didn't want it to look like a doctor's office, she didn't want it to look like a hospital. She didn't want it to look like a clinic. And so what this looks like and feels like is a rather large but very well-appointed home. And I think a lot of the women and men that come here look on it like that. It's like their second home. They come here, and like they can in their own home, they can be themselves.
It's not just about the money. It's about people being aware of Gildathon being here and the purpose of it, what it does for people in the community, and I hope that from that people know about it and do donate whatever it is, whether it's $2 or $200 or maybe they can donate their time by volunteering and teaching a class here or whatever it might be. So that's what I hope comes out of the Gildathon.
I have to admit that this place makes me really, really emotional. Even though I lost my own father to a heart attack and heart disease in the end, we found out about his heart because of cancer. My grandmother died of cancer. My grandfather died of cancer. My uncle, my beloved uncle, died of cancer. If anyone of those people had had this place, hell, if I'd had this place, it would have been fucking amazing. So I hope, with whatever you're going through, that you give the Red Door a chance. Because believe me, behind this door, you will find love and laughter and a real shining example of what humanity is. So we invite you to come to Gildathon Club November the 18th, noon 7, and take a look at Gildathon.
Isn't it remarkable? Like every time a raindrop falls, it's just Please don't throw.